Hello everybody, this is Tech Stack here. This is Season 3, Episode 9, the finale, the great finale. Yes, it is true, we are going to be doing Tribes, guys. Everybody on the server is excited. Some of the people on YouTube are excited. This is going to be fun. Basically, enough votes have been casted that I can go ahead and call it. I think I had one no vote out of all my server members that have voted so far, and I've had like 13 or 14 people vote, and everybody but that one person wanted to do Tribes. So we're going to be resetting this map, which, by the way, everybody wanted to reset the map, so we will be doing that for sure. We'll be doing Tribes, the Tribes themselves. There's going to be four leaders that'll do YouTube, and I have had probably four or five more server members say that they will be recording for sure, and a couple that have said I might be. That is awesome. If we can get as many different points of view of this thing as possible, that'd be great. You know, in my case, I can't always record during the day, but some of the other guys would be, so we might be able to. For you YouTubers, subscribers, be able to provide you a picture of what's going on the server almost all the time, if that's the case. I'm sure there'll be lots of group videos where two or three people record different perspectives of events and things like that, but it's just going to make a great viewing experience, I think, for everybody involved. It's going to be lots of fun for our server members, too. Over on the TSCraft 2 server, which I might take you to in a little bit here, we've been working out a spawn area, and it's just a starting area. No real supplies will be put in there other than some basic things that just really will help the overall server performance and things like that. Some miscraft pages so that people don't have to create a bunch of junk miscraft pages. We're not giving everybody, or the tribes, I should say, all of the pages, just a few starting ones to help out. Things like that. Excuse my alarm here. Sorry about that. I got up a little bit early today and beat my alarm up. Anyway, what was I saying? We're really going to be doing tribes and you know, some of the rules of things that we've come up with since I've made the video announcing that we might do tribes. You know, we've decided on four different colors for the tribes. Those four different colors will be an indication of which tribe you're on, and it's going to be something that you have to wear on your helmet, just your helmet. Now, players are more than welcome to wear the rest of the armor if they want, that's colored, but you must have your helmet in the color of your tribe at all times. The only exception would be like if you get in a battle, like you've started a battle and your helmet breaks. You know, you're allowed to not have it then, so you can finish the battle, but as soon as it's over or whatever, you need to get the proper helmet color on. That way it's just clear to everybody that's playing which team you're on. I think that's a really good idea, partially because maybe initially everybody's going to be decided where they want to go, but somebody that's on that team over there might split and go over here. So having a different color will really help with that. Having it marked on each player. But yeah, that's the main rule. We've thought through some other ones. They're still kind of in the works. We'll probably get together the four leaders of the tribes and make sure that everybody's on the same page with all the rest of the stuff we've been discussing. Who's the leaders? That's probably one thing that everybody wants to know. I'm going to be a tribe leader. Pixel's going to be a tribe leader, or GoTanksMC, that's his YouTube channel. iJordan's going to be a leader, which is YJordan on YouTube, and Alcoa's going to be a leader. He has asked that, you know, he be the one that leads the fourth tribe. I'm more than happy to have him do that. He said he's going to start a YouTube channel up, so once I get his YouTube channel name, I will be letting everybody on my channel know. We're going to be doing some collaborative things on YouTube here, all the four of us, and also the rest of the guys that do want to record that makes up the tribes. Example, I'm working on creating an intro for all this tribe stuff, and I'm going to share it with everybody so we have a consistent feel on YouTube. I thought that was kind of important if we're going to be doing this. Not trying to copy the Minecraft guys in their UHC series, but I like the way that they've done things, at least recently in the last couple seasons of their UHC, where they've all, or at least some of them, have shared an intro video, and it just makes them all look as though they're one message being sent out in one season, really. I mean, it's really a show at that point when you start doing things like that. So anyway, just kind of wanted to announce that. Some other things of interest. This server, this is the last video I will be making of the server. And in fact, while I keep talking here, I'll probably just fly around so people can see some of the things that others have done. In fact, let's go back to spawn. And tonight, this server is going to go down. It will probably be down until the weekend. That's my initial thought on this whole thing. The server's going to go down tonight. The server will be down because I'm going to take everybody off the whitelist, going to delete the whitelist, going to start a fresh server on this thing. I'm going to start to add mods into the mod pack. Mo creatures is the one I'm going to try and get added into the pack. If that works successfully, we will be playing with more creatures or mo creatures. Mod. Hello, zombie. You, by the way, if by some great chance the maker of soul shards ever sees this video, please make it so we can create a tier 5 baby villager zombie spawner. I know that sounds kind of ridiculous. Why would anybody want that? Because those guys are crazy fast. I want it for custom maps. That would just be a beast of a spawner if you can get those guys to spawn. They would be their own boss in my levels if I did that. Anyway, sorry for the sidetrack there. We're adding more creatures. The reason I'm testing it out and taking the server down is I don't know that... it's going to be a good add to the server. I've heard some of my other server members say that they've added it to their servers or to their single player games and have had issues with it. Issues being it just takes over the mob spawns and all you get is more creatures, or more creatures mobs. You really don't get the vanilla mobs like you should. And I don't want that. I want the vanilla experience or the other mods to be able to spawn their creatures in. I want zombies. I want creepers. I want skeletons. Because that's a part of the game. I mean, you need the bone meal from skeletons. You need the arrows. That type of thing. So I just don't want it to overcrowd things. Because what they were saying was, you know, you might get elephants in a biome that makes no sense, like the snow biome over there. And there'd be 50 of them on that hill. So I need to get in and I need to configure the settings for it to make it reasonable, I guess is what I'm going for. I'd like the Mo Creatures mods to spawn, but I'd like them to spawn in at a very reduced rate. At least from what I've heard, the default configs are. You know, that makes sense to me. So anyway, I know I've just kind of flown around here, haven't explained any of this. This is our spawn village. I'm just going to keep this video short, so what you've seen is probably what you're going to get as far as a little bit of a world-ending tour here. I'll probably make a backup copy of our world and just tuck it away somewhere if we ever want to come back someday. But I doubt it. I doubt anybody's going to want to come back here after what we're going to do. Everybody seems so excited about the tribes thing. And I don't remember if I said it in this video or not already, but the tribes, did everybody want to do that one? I think I've had around 14 people vote. 14 of 14 people wanted to reset the map. 13 of 14 wanted to do tribes. So that's pretty crazy. The voting hasn't stopped yet. they still have till this evening, really, to vote. But I'm with that many people already voted, and it's pretty much unanimous. Definitely on the map reset, I know I'm going to be able to take a server down without causing anybody any problems. So, anyway, this is TechStack signing off on Season 3. Be on the lookout for Tribes. It's going to be coming this weekend, and I'm sure there will be lots and lots of videos up on YouTube. It sounds like most of my server wants to record it now. So, hey guys, I couldn't leave you hanging with that last video by itself. I had to give you a little bit of a taste of Tribes. And that's what this is. We over on the TSCraft 2 server have been working out our spawn area, just playing through it in our mind what it's going to look like. Ignore the stuff in the background, that's our other maps. But this square of grass here is how the thing's going to work. We are going to have literally lines drawn in the ground that divide the tribes. Spawn's kind of going to be a little bit of a neutral area, or at least a little bit more than normal neutral of an area. I had some say in this, but my tribe, my server members had a lot to do with this. They did a lot of the design work here. Treyer had the awesome idea of putting MFFS force field, or not force fields, defense stations and security stations and things like that encased in blocks that no one can get to, so that the tribe leaders can come down here, hit this thing, set up their tribe's IDs into this master controller here. Everybody would have access to the secure storage then. Everybody would be able to enter these colored bases, and it, you know, set their spawn up here on top of these bases. It just makes for the four tribes to have a private area on the map where they can store their gear when they die, things like that. If you didn't notice, stuck on a block. Which one was it? Not that one. Not that one. This one here. This is going to be how the wall will extend beyond spawn. You know, spawn, it's going to be open. The tribes can cross the border here very easily. They still can cross the border out here, but they have to make a effort to do it. They have to break the post for the fence down. This wall I plan to extend 1,000 blocks in that direction. And the bedrock piece that you're seeing below it will go down to bedrock. There will be no tunneling underneath, and I will probably extend this portion of it all the way across through spawn even. No one will be crossing the border underground. I just want it to be obvious that there is a declaration of war basically being made by crossing the border, or maybe not necessarily declaration of war, but hostilities could arise from crossing the border, and I want it to be obvious that someone is crossing the border. You know, if there's two people on the server at the same time, red team here and green team there, or lime team there, red can see green's crossing their borders. Didn't want anybody sneaking about it. Anyway, obviously once they get across, they could tunnel on under the ground. Oop. Derpy me. They could tunnel under the ground and get to their destination. That bedrock plate here is just going to be beneath spawn, so no one does anything funny to spawn itself. But yeah, I just wanted to show off what we're working on. This is still a work in progress. I'm sure it'll change by the weekend, which is when I plan to open up the server for everybody to start playing Tribes. Don't have an exact time. I just know it's probably going to be this weekend. So anyway, this will be me actually signing off this time. I originally recorded my sign-off, but decided to add in a little bit more of a teaser here for Tribes. But anyway, this is TechStack signing off. Have a good day now. See you in Tribes.